children's rank. A soundbite. Is it any wonder I'm tired? Is it any wonder that I feel uptight? Is it any wonder I don't know what's right? All these days, after all the misery and pain, is it any wonder that I feel afraid? Is it any wonder that I feel betrayed?
Hello, everyone. Hello, Rhino. Hello, Murdoch. Hello, Bitbat. Hello, Nezyak. Hello, Comic Coon. Dude, I need a new chair. Hey, Ephron. How are you doing today, besides cold? Cold. That's really the best answer. New chair falling apart? No! I need a new chair. I've had this chair for a bit now. But yeah, it is falling apart. where's my reference? There it is. Dude, I thought about it. I thought about just, like, getting up, getting ready for the day, then crawling back into my cocoon to stream. I do have stuff to do today, so I decided to get out of bed. And because I got out of bed, I figured I might as well stream. So. Should be uploading your next commentary either today or tomorrow. Fair enough, fair enough. I'm still working on my next com. Dude, honestly, to anyone who thought that I lost my edge in 2018 or 2017, whenever that started rolling around, because I don't entirely remember anymore, they're in for a surprise for this next video. Because I throw in some pretty edgy jokes, actually. very much a return to form, but for the better. Who's this Swole Lad? Swole Lass, and it is my Cyclops girl, Iris. Maybe I could do a better job at showing that. Susie's getting her edge back. It makes sense in context. Like, all the edgy jokes that I make sense in context. And it's not like I'm going around throwing around the N-word. So, it's not the worst aspects of old school doodle tones, but it is very much... It's very much, like, very old school doodle. So anyone who ever missed, like, my darker sense of humor, like, you're gonna get that in the next video. I don't know if anyone here even cared about those times, but I remember there was a lot of people who did at one point. Like, I've made it no secret what it is I'm covering. They show up on this stream and ask about it every once in a while. Well, I more explain to them every once in a while, like, what the progress is on it. But yeah. It's gonna be very nostalgic, I feel. In the best way. Yeah. Character is buff. I'm not doing a particularly good job at demonstrating that, I don't think, but... You guys have been able to tell, so maybe I'm doing better than I thought. Like Samus with the armor on. It's not exactly the vibe I wanted to go for, but sure thing. sketch is looking very, very gross, but... This is why I said I needed the extra time. Kind of reminds me of a Charged and Shot. You know what? I am doing it wrong. That's what's bothering me about this. I'm doing it wrong. I'm just kind of like... I'm not using a reference for buff people like I should have been. I'm just kind of like trying to wing it. You have a riddle? Sure. What's your riddle?
It's Leviosa.
Hey, Nazi. It's both long and short, short but also tall. A snake?
Sorry, I told you I was gonna do it to you at least one time.
Fair enough.
So what's going on?
Someone's asking me a riddle. It's, what is both long and short, short but also tall, and I responded with, a snake? It's technically correct, but I don't know if that's the answer to the riddle.
I don't know, a stack of pancakes. I don't fucking know.
A slinky?
What are you...
Oh, okay.
What are you playing?
Not playing. I'm drawing.
Oh, okay.
I really haven't been doing a lot of, like, gaming streams. Like, I've been doing... Ghost of a Tale, because you also want to finish Mouse Game. But that's really about it. Oh shit, I shouldn't have left that going. That's one of those songs that I need to find and take out of my playlist. Cause it's copywritten. It could get me in trouble. Does anyone here know how to turn on onion skin in Clip Studio Paint? No, I don't.
Why would you need onion skin? Are you doing it for an animation or a drawing?
I don't know, someone just in the chat's asking.
Because if you're doing it for animation, it should be near the frames of the timeline. I need to get back into animating. I'm no lazy fuck.
Mm-hmm.
my arm hurts like hell because I was playing fucking Nintendo Sports. I haven't felt this kind of pain since fucking 2008. Oh boy. I'm just tired and I can't sleep. Can I see what you're drawing?
You're
not screen sharing. You're not doing it. It makes me sad. Why you not do? Why you like to make me sad? Oh my god! By the way, you know how I said that when we're not streaming Dragon Quest, I'll grind off screen, right?
You have been doing that.
No, I have been.
Oh, okay.
In fact, I think I've grinded too much.
Oh.
Cause I... So, okay. In Dragon Quest, right, there comes a certain point where... You know how, like, the monsters will see you and they'll run towards you when you're new to an area?
Sure.
So, when you're too experienced for an area, they'll start to run away from you? That's where we're at. Apparently, we were just the right level for the keep when we were getting, like, the red orb. And so you're supposed to be around level 12 when you first meet Serena, who's the girl that we're trying to save with Veronica at the moment, right? I'm currently level 16.
I see.
I want to see if I can get to level 20 before the next stream, because I think it'd be really hilarious to see Brooke's reaction. I'm a fucking god.
Dude, I remember getting to level 20-something before I started going to the first gym in, Emerald. That was very funny. Like, I think I evolved my Pokemon, like, most of my Pokemon by the time I got to the first gym.
I need to play Violet. I need to get back into streaming. I kind of stopped streaming for a little while. My brain just hasn't been so hot.
I need to get, like, Scarlet or Violet, whichever, or... Problem is I'm not gonna lie, I'm not feeling a lot of these Pokemon. There's some that I really like. I went in and looked at the Pokedex, and what have you, spoiled myself for the entire dex. Mostly because I wanted to see what the final Evos for the starters looked like, I'm not really feeling any of them, frankly.
Don't spoil any for me.
I'm not going to, but I'm not really. As far as the final Evos go, I'm not feeling them.
Go to No Mic real quick.
That's funny.
You could always name him Mary Jane. have you seen Cogsire?
Cogsire. Oh, yeah, the new Quagsire? Yeah.
I love him.
I do love him.
Have you seen... Someone made a plushie of him, and I love him.
Have you seen the, did you remember before the game came out, there was, like, a picture going around of, like, a map, and it had some, like, mice on it?
I actually don't. I don't think I ever saw that.
Yep. I now know what the mice, Pokemon is. You're gonna love them.
Oh my god.
That is probably going to be one of your favorite Pokemon from this generation. I'm not going to spoil. Huh?
Is it in the starter area?
I have no idea where they're at. I just saw them and I just went on to Bulbapedia and Serebii and looked at all the Pokemon. You're going to love the mice.
You can join me on the stream. See if we can find the mice. You can get my reaction.
Yeah.
Somebody made a live 2D model of Sprigatito so that you can have it next to you while you stream, and now I kind of want to make one for the other two. I can make one for Smoliv, and... Oh, I can make one for Wooper. Sorry,
that's
what were you saying?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, the thing is I kind of want to play the game myself. I don't have it. I also don't want to play it while it's in the glitchy state that it's apparently in.
That's one of the reasons why I'm excited to play the game. It's because I want to see if my copy got fucked. I'm also wary about the videos where it is, like, really fucked because people have modded their Switches and emulated the games, and I really wish that people would be honest about whether or not they've done that.
But I've seen a bunch. Ton of glitches of the game. I've seen at least two accounts of people, like, clipping through the world.
Yeah, I saw that. I think my favorite so far is somebody was, like, trying to catch a Wooper that was in the water, and their boy Coco was, like, on the edge, and it fell asleep and then fell into the water.
Yeah, I saw that.
This boy Coco, no!
Yeah, I'm gonna wait a bit before I even try to get the game, because knowing my luck with video games, and my chat can vouch for me, the minute I start playing a game that is that glitchy, I'm going to find a way to softlock it. So I'm just not. I'm just gonna wait. Susie, you can't get out of this section. Observe! As I do it accidentally.
What the fuck is this?
What?
I went on Twitter real quick. You know what Manscaped is, right?
Yeah.
They just put out a tweet that says shave your balls in all caps and then rewritten like 16 times.
Okay.
It's just a wall of text that says shave your balls.
All right.
And I was kind of laughing because sometimes I'll sit there and I'll think about the fucking where are you? And I'm so sorry. Reminded me of that song again.
I just thought it was really funny that Girly Wolf Puppet I did it in the exact same fucking night.
It was so funny. And I'm so sorry. Like a little, I just like to imagine that all of us, like in the party, are in the same room. And this little girl is up and she's crying in front of us. And Brooke is trying to comfort her, and in the backseat, she's like, and I'm so sorry. Little girl's like still fucking crying.
Look, all I'm saying is I too can be pop punk trash.
Oh, it's so stupid. Oh, boy.
Also, I love how someone has started arguing with me that Scarlet and Violet isn't that glitchy. They're like, oh, there's only three problems and they're not that big. I'd say clipping through the world is a pretty big issue, my dude.
Yeah. I'm not saying that the glitches aren't big. I'm also wary about where the glitches are coming from. Because it's like a 50-50 shot for some people. Some people's games are fucked. Other people's games are like totally fine except for about a frame rate. And because people did hack their Sword and Shield games to get like shitty visuals, I'm very not trusting of people online when it comes to those types of things. Like, my goodwill on those types of videos has been kind of spent. Also, Tumblr is starting to hire the Twitter people that Elon Musk fired. Tumblr is starting... Did I say Twitter is starting to hire?
You said Tumblr.
Okay.
Neat. See, I was dusting off some of my old social medias this morning while I was in my... you could call it a cocoon, because it was very, very cold this morning, and I didn't want to get out of my... I didn't want to get out of my caterpillar state. But yeah, I was dusting off my old social medias. I'm still trying to figure out how to use Tumblr, but I think I figured out how to use Reddit, so that'll be fun.
Oh no!
It's fine, I can just dwell on the wholesome Reddits. I planned on it anyway.
I need to get good things wherever I can get them.
Yeah, no, I, what was it? I got on, I logged back into my Reddit and immediately started following r slash trans. It's like, I'll take wholesome where I can get it. World fucking cold and hard and I don't like it.
Might not want to refer to people as hard, but all right.
Said world, but okay.
Hey, Earthchan does her best. I remember I saw a post not too long ago of like, well, if you like it, or if you don't like how Twitter's being run, then you get $44 billion and buy it. It's like, dude, if I had $44 billion, I would not fucking spend it on Twitter.
It's true.
I'd fucking set up my family, I'd set up my friends, just send my friends like $1 billion each, and then I'd fucking be on my way. Like probably give the rest of it to charity because I thought about it, right? Having that much money, it's like, oh, I can do this, this, and that. And then there's like still a pile left, and I'm like, I don't know what the fuck to do with the rest of this. Like hoarding it feels wrong, probably because it kind of is.
I mean, realistically, what would you do with $1 million anyway? You're in Japan.
$44 billion.
Oh, $1 billion. Point is, you're in Japan.
You can convert it.
Yes, but what would you do with the dollars? You'd have to convert them.
Yeah,
I am being a
you can.
smart ass.
I mean, if it's all digital, it kind of does that automatically. If you're buying anything online, or if you're like going to a bank. You could just deposit, you could just withdraw it.
I'm being a smart ass, Nezzy.
Yeah, you are, and you're being really bad at
Well, because then they're not
Well, guess who's
dollars
not
anymore.
getting the hypothetical $1 billion?
Look, I'm just saying. I'm just saying. When you convert that money, it's no longer dollars.
Oh no, a fuck ton of yen. What will I do? Oh no, my PayPal, it's broken with all of my money.
My point is just to argue semantics, and that's all I was doing. I wasn't arguing in sincerity.
But genuinely though, having that much money feels wrong. It's like having the whole Monopoly board. There's no point. There's no point. There's no competition. You own the whole thing. I know I do that occasionally to bully the CPU to feel some kind of superiority, but that's not the point.
Okay.
To make a
I've
long
found
story.
that one of the best ways to de-stress is go to Monopoly, set all the AI to super easy, buy the whole board, and then watch them all die. It's so fun.
To make a long story short, I shoved an entire bag of jelly beans up my ass.
That doesn't sound as fun. What if they melt? What are you gonna do then, fuckwit?
Shit's rainbows.
Just fucking just one massive shit. You give birth to a one whole jelly bean.
Isn't that how the jelly beans are made?
No, they're shot out by the Easter Bunny. Fucking pick up on your lore. Dumbass, don't you know where jelly beans come from? That's one hell of a sentence. Dumbass doesn't know where chili beans come from.
Riveting.
Is the imp concerned for you?
Yeah, I'm not the one who just shoved an entire bag of jelly beans up my head.
Yeah. That should tell you how concerned I am for you.
We need to take you to a doctor.
You know who else we need to take to the doctor?
You.
Yeah. I was almost expected to, for TP to just cut in with my mom, and then I just go, no, dumb shit, me, I've still got stomach problems.
Yes, Snoozy is your mom.
God.
You know who else is my mom?
Your mom.
My mom?
In my little bed, filled with joy, holding my plush. Like a little gremlin man, I am surrounded by trinkets.
Oh yeah, speaking of plushes.
Uh-huh.
Did you see what just recently came out?
What?
Recently announced?
What?
Did you see what was recently announced?
What was recently announced?
Hold on, let me go grab the tweet.
The big ass weed cat?
No. I don't think white.
The giant field plush?
The big ass gay duck.
Okay, I'm just gonna post it in no mic, okay? I'm posting in no mic.
Oh.
Oh shit! It's your baby that took you forever to catch in Pokemon Legends.
I would do it again.
Baby. It's the baby.
Speaking of things that are taking me forever to catch. Y'all want to hear about this really cool video? This really cool... You want to see what version of the Pokemon I got?
You got the Sonic version.
Yeah.
Also, speaking of things that are taking fucking forever, I need to send your goddamn package that I bought you months ago.
You don't.
Imagine having a package.
You would have one if you fucking let me.
No.
Bitch. You don't get to complain then.
I'm not complaining. I am merely joking. Cause I know you wanted to send me stuff.
Bitch, I swear to God. What did you say, TP?
If you found a way to include that in the package, I would die.
Fine.
I'll pay you.
I know you will. I'll wait on sending you the package then. Wait for this fuck to come out. Buy that fuck for my lovable fuck right here. When does it come out? 26? Okay.
I still say one of the funniest realizations that I've had in the past bit has been that technically people could buy my docs if they knew what my mom's eBay was.
I know. And I am very tempted.
I don't even know what my mom's eBay is, so... I just think it's one of the funniest realizations that I've had. Is Doom copyright free? Well, it doesn't get my VOD muted, and that's all that matters to me.
Morning.
Homosexual.
Fuck.
Yeah, the move Zinni. There he is.
I'm just kidding. It's Scaly.
I shouldn't enter just all nice and goody two shoes. I should have flipped the tables on this one.
Wait for that now. One of the funniest reactions I ever saw. Right, I was watching someone play a video game. It was a horror game, and there was a ghost woman that came in, but instead of screaming ghost or monster, he started screaming white woman.
Is that where white woman jump scare came from?
No, the other thing. Okay, so when he panics, this is Daz Black, by the way. I love him so much. He's so funny. But when he panics, his brain just goes to like a specific descriptor, and then he repeats it. So one time there was like a shadow ghost that was walking around. He just started shouting black man.
Oh no! No!
Black man! Just like, oh no! It was so funny! I just want to know what his neighbors were thinking! I suddenly have the urge to draw Slime Girl.
I still woke up only recently, so pardon me if I'm feeling bleh, groggy. I don't know.
That's fine.
Yeah. Oh.
How dare I what? Feel tired? What,
yes.
What do you want me to do? Go back to bed? maybe I will. I don't know. For a moment, I thought you were drawing a zombie, but now I see where the slime girl came from.
Yeah.
resist one.
Bless you.
Aw, oh, man. Just... You get the feeling whenever you feel like you're about to sneeze, but it never happens?
Yeah, what I do is I typically go... I typically lift my head up and look at the ceiling light. That typically helps.
You know, I'm actually kind of surprised at this, but I... guys, Sonic Frontiers is actually really fun. Look at that.
From what I saw, yeah. Like, I don't really see what much of the fuss is about.
No, the fuss is about Sonic fans. Or maybe people that are not Sonic fans, you know? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's the exact opposite problem. Point is... The problem isn't with the game, from what I've been understanding.
It's with both sides of the... It's both the opposite ends of the extreme. Like, the people who hate Sonic and the ones who care too much about it.
Yeah,
I wouldn't say too
like
much,
that.
But like a lot.
Something like that. Basically, okay. Frontiers... truly, like, emphasizes the internet's want to just look at things exclusively negatively and nothing more than that.
Or fuck it.
Cause, like... I'll fully admit it's not perfect, but anyone who knows me knows my favorite game is Sonic Adventure, and that's my favorite Sonic game is Adventure, and that's not perfect either.
I think there's definitely some stuff in there where there was some funny stuff that was not intentional, because there's like a moment where I got into a boss fight and I left the area with the boss fight and the music just stops, and then when you come back it picks up again.
Oh yes. Yeah,
and it's just Sonic is like, wow, this is a really great area, and there's like a god behind him fucking up the planet. It's like, this is not the time.
I think this game can be really funny at times. In that regard.
I like the expressions. Expressions look great.
Yeah, I've been told by Avi that I might like this one, despite the fact that I'm not a big Sonic fan. So... maybe. Maybe I'll try to pick it up.
I think Avi has a point.
That I'd like it?
Yeah.
Maybe.
I know, I'd probably like it. I grew up on the freaking Sonic Unleashed on the Xbox of all things, so that's gonna tell you. So that'll tell you what freaking rocky start I got.
Yeah, this definitely gives me a lot of This does give like a lot of a Sonic Unleashed vibes too, with how some things are done and
you know, like the combat.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get so split, I'll see you guys later. Alright,
see ya.
Oh, you're going? Okay.
Yeet.
You take care.
What's going, Murdoch? I'm just kind of still waking up.
Since Mage.
I always kind of wondered what makes a slime blue flavored.
Blue flavored.
You're thinking it too.
No, actually, I wasn't.
We all have at some point.
Maybe now, but not before.
Like, you're telling me blue raspberry doesn't exist, so where does the blue come from?
Okay.
I'm sorry. That was a freaking off kilter.
You know what? Fair.
All I'm saying is, if we can make artificial flavoring, why can't we just make it natural flavoring? Why can't we just make blue raspberries an actual thing? Pardon?
You know why we can't make blue raspberries a natural thing?
Why?
Because I said so.
Man. Screw you, I'm gonna make blue raspberries. I'm gonna make blue flavor real.
The blue flavor is real!
I have seen it!
By the way, something that I'm doing with this character in particular that I don't do with literally any of the other slimes is the little silhouette inside it. Because if you look at my other slime characters, if you look at, like, say, this character, they don't have a silhouette inside. Or if you look at my character Bonnie, she doesn't have a silhouette inside. But this one does.
She's special.
So does that mean, so does that make the other two slime girls thicker? The viscosity of the fluid makes it so it's not transparent. So does that mean the slime is more thick with them?
That's not the idea.
You bring me to these brain rots. I.
I don't know why that was the question that came to mind.
I am a man of science. Whenever it intrigues me.
But no, it's actually less because this guy's even slime to begin with.
Oh.
He's a water elemental.
Oh, nice.
But everyone was sitting there calling him a slime. I'm like, there's something that I do with him that I don't do with my other slimes. Because, like, Bonnie and Hanasu, the other two that I showed on the screen, they are just full-on slime. This guy's a water elemental. And I'm going to be drawing my fire elemental here in a sec.
Nice.
I think it's really funny that, like, that's becoming, like, a fucking bit again because of the new fucking Disney movie. But, I've had Aqua and Ember for a time now.
I don't know why my head just defaulted to Fireboy and Water Girl, was it? Yeah, the Cool Math game there.
Yeah, there's that one too. I've seen that. That wasn't the idea, but they've been around a lot longer than my fire and water elemental.
Like, I didn't really know what, like, Disney movie you were referencing with these two elementals. So, like, the only other thing I could think of was freaking Shark Boy and Lava Girl. That didn't sound right.
Well, there's an, I don't remember what the Disney movie is called, but it's one with, like, a water boy, or, like a big water dude, and then, like, a fire girl.
Oh, It might have been, like, a short of some kind?
No, it's like a movie. It's a movie coming out.
Oh, it's coming out. Okay, I thought it was already in on DVD or something.
Oh, it's literally called Elemental.
Ah, all right.
I love how, by the way, when I search that up, how I get fucking the fire boy and water girl in related images. everyone's just making the joke that these two are trans. It's really funny, actually.
I really like the art style on these, than the little sneak peeks so far.
Yeah, I have no idea what it's about. I don't know anything about it other than the fact that it's coming out.
Calling it now, these two will hold hands.
I mean, seeing the one poster for it, maybe. Yeah, it's coming out next year? Yeah, by the looks of it.
Yeah, 2023?
Yeah, apparently there's a movie coming out called Strange World. I don't think I've heard anything about that.
Oh, I've heard... I've seen, like, trailers and stuff for it. It doesn't really... I don't know. It doesn't exactly sell me on the premise, per se.
You know what I know the thing is? The only thing I know about the movie is that apparently it's the... I know first gay whatever is overdone, but it's the first time it, like, the protagonist is gay, and the feeling of gay, of they're gay, is actually discussed as a plot point or something in the movie. Which, you know, tells you exactly why you've heard nothing about it.
Probably not, I guess. Although, with that premise, I would think I'd hear more about it. Mostly from people complaining.
Eh, I'm a little, I don't know if annoyed is the right word, but I kind of miffed at the approach to these trailers, like they did with Encanto. It's like, they don't exactly show what the plot is going to be about, and more of, like, the premise of who these characters are and what they do, I guess. What world do they live in?
I don't know.
Oh, this is a strange world. These people have strange skills that they use to live in this strange world. Wow. How wacky.
I'm wacky.
I'm woobly. Don't ask me how I know that.
I wanted to see what this was about real quick. Do they have a premise for it? Do they not have a premise for it? They don't, do they? They don't. Huh? I'm not seeing anything. Huh?
As legendary family of explorers whose differences threaten to topple their latest and most crucial mission into uncharted
Strange
territory.
World.
Fuck.
Not Strange World.
Dang, wrong film. Damn it. What am I?
I was looking at Elemental and Wish, but like I'm not finding anything on those.
Okay. At least it's good to know that Strange World does have like a plot going for it, I guess. It's a little vague on that part, as far as I can tell, but yeah.
Dude, I love how these production companies are giving like no love to anything that they're releasing, and then wondering why their stuff's doing so bad. Like, didn't Netflix had like a movie that was like getting really popular this year, and I didn't even hear about it until like a month after it was released because people on Twitter were starting to talk about it. I don't even remember what the fucking thing was. Hold on, let me. Netflix movie. I think it had a. It was about skeletons, was it? No. What the fuck was it called? Oh, there it is. Hold on. Wendell and Wild. That.
Oh yes. Oh, that movie was so good.
I haven't seen it yet, but like I didn't even know that it was a thing because Netflix didn't talk, or I think it was Netflix. Point is, wherever it's at, it didn't. It was not advertised. Period.
I don't recall if they had advertisements on from Netflix. I remember seeing it popping up on Twitter. Like how the animation looks so cool, and it does. The story is so cool. I love it.
Like they don't advertise their stuff, and they wonder why these things do so bad, and so they don't persist to do things correctly because they don't look at, like, what people like about it or some shit. It's like why, Owl House is only getting the third season it's getting is because fucking Disney execs, fucking didn't pay attention to how many people actually like the Owl House and was just like, oh, well, no, nobody's caring about this movie. Let's just fuck, or not a movie. Nobody's caring about this show. Let's just get rid of it. Like,
And then
these studios, or
see Will Too Late, the freaking outcry on the season 3 premiere. Whoops, a little late for that, guys. Back to the drawing board, I guess.
There's also fucking what was it like? Just generally, like how many times have we heard the story of like a show getting fucking canned because they don't run it on air? Cartoon Network, we're looking at you, buddy.
Nickelodeon.
Nick. Man, you're really bad at that. And then fucking HBO Max looks at all of these shows and is just like, well, I mean, let's just get rid of them. Like, fuck off.
Except for that one episode of Uncle Grandpa.
No, that was a fucking cry for help. That's what that was. God, I. Can we, like, start treating artists and animators better? Like.
Yes, please. It's shit like this that makes me question it, how good the entertainment industry has it. It's like with all the stuff behind the scenes, or like the crunch times and the I don't know. It's shit like this that makes me question college.
Did you, like, go to college for animation?
No, I've been trying to apply to it, but, like, nah, it's not going anywhere. Nah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just... Fuck, man. This year... Like, I don't even profess to be an artist, and it's still a fucking exhausting year for me. Just to see all that stuff. See all these people get treated like fucking filth.
Yeah. Ah, shit.
Dude, I want to pick up Toon Boom, actually. Because I think it'd be really cool to learn, like, that puppet animation stuff. Mm-hmm. And then... fucking reanimate my lore.
Oh, that
sounds
awesome.
Like, straight up animate. I would love to do that. But Toon Boom's expensive.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I guess it could get the Yar Har discount, if I really wanted to. But. I don't have, like, the space on my computer for something like that either. So.
Yeah.
But I would love.
Does it take up more space with the Yar Har discount, or is it just the program in general?
I imagine the program's pretty big, considering it's, like, studio level.
Yeah, I get you.
It's kind of how Blender is, like, a ridiculously big program, and I would also like to learn that, but I have no space on my computer for that. I download Blender and my computer's just like, feel free to fucking delete it at any time, please. It's like, okay.
I tried installing that on my freaking old as hell laptop at one point and just chugging the biggest of bricks.
Yo, thank you for the follow, Shane the Hellhound. Thank you for the bits, and hello, welcome to the chat. I hope you enjoy your stay. But yeah, I don't know. I have a lot of ambitions, but, like, I'm never gonna get any of those ambitions done.
Yeah.
Like, I'd love to, like, animate my lore. I feel like that would be better than drawing fucking 5 billion fucking sprites. I would love to, I mean, honestly, I'd kind of love to make a game off of my lore. That'd be fun. But,
what kind of game?
I actually have thought about this. So if I was to build something that was kind of, like, based on my lore, it would probably be something a little bit, like, like the puzzle exploration. With a little bit of like I'd probably put in, I don't know if I would want to say, I don't know if I'd want to call it like dating sim mechanics.
Yeah.
But
I was about to ask if it was a dating sim.
No, it wouldn't be a dating sim, but it would have like those mechanics where like the more you hang out with someone, like the friendlier they are to you.
Ah, okay.
So is like
something like Zero Escape?
I guess. I've never played that, so I wouldn't know. But okay. That would be something that would come to mind. The characters would be like just kind of around in like the ship. You'd be able to explore the ship as to your whim. And each of the AU characters, like each of the doodles, would have their own like schedule. So like you'd find like if you'd have like an in-game clock you could look at, and then at a certain time you'll find like certain AU doodles around the ship. So like typically you'd be able to find like Annabelle during the library, but let's just say, it's just as an example, like maybe the in-game 6 p.m. she's like in the lounge or some shit like that, or maybe she's in her room or some shit like that, you know, stuff like that. So like the characters would be going around and doing their schedules as they normally do. And you'd be able to go around and talk to them. They would probably give you, like, missions or quests or whatever to find or complete certain other tasks, to which that's where the puzzle exploration, aspect of the game would come in. I've thought about this. I'd also have an idea for, like, little collectibles you could get. And you'd be able to use those collectibles in, like, a mini game. I have also thought of like a card system thing to for that mini game in particular. Like it wouldn't be required for anything unless you were like 100%ing it.
Oh, nice.
But like because I have a card game, I've like a developed card game, I could literally start selling at any time. I just haven't done it yet. Like, I've thought about it. Like the arcade where the characters are could have like their own little mini games to it as well. That could get you certain collectibles. Like it's I know how I would design it. It's almost like it's almost like I took game design classes for this kind of exact purpose. But I don't have the stuff for to do what I'd want to do. Like, cause obviously I'd want it to be like more of like a kind of like a 3D game. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to use Blender. And I can't use Blender because my computer is toaster.
Yeah, fair enough.
I could probably learn how to, like, code something in, like, Unreal or Unity. Whichever. Like, that wouldn't be a problem. Especially since I've spent time learning that stuff, too. I have learned how to code. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Those are just, it's just something that I think about sometimes. You ever get a new computer, would you want a desktop or a laptop? Oh, definitely a desktop. I need a new laptop. Because my laptop is actually older than my desktop. And my desktop is, like, at least 9 years old? So... But, yeah, I need a new laptop, but I prefer using desktop. Laptop is just there for whenever I go to, like, my uncle's or something. Or, like, I'm away from my computer, I can still work. But I can't do shit all on my laptop. It's even more of a toaster. Like, If I turned it on at the start of a stream, like if I just started up a stream and then turned on my laptop, it would be by the end of the stream that it would just finish booting up.
Oh no.
It's trash. I actually tried using that laptop, actually, to, learn, Mario 64 modding. And that's actually where my test mod is. It's on that laptop. Like, fun fact for those who did not know, before I just opted into being a YouTuber, I wanted to be a game designer. Hmm. But, obviously we can't all follow our dreams, so. I wanted to do game design, and I wanted to, like, there was a point in time where I wanted to make, like, little cartoons and stuff, too, of my little doodle series. And I do neither of those things anymore. Or, like, I say anymore as if I ever started, but, yeah. And then I've always wanted to pick up music as a hobby, and guess what I also don't do, so. Like, literally everything that I've wanted to do in my life, I do, like, the exact opposite now. It's kind of funny. What exactly is your character, the Void? He is the Void.
He's the Void. All are temporary. He is forever.
look at the little guy. He is the Void.
The more mine. Dork Teepee. You are totally precious.
You shut the hell up.
If you want to like a more specific answer, he was something that I got from the results of a random Pokemon generator. And I loved him. So I drew him and kept him around. Because he is the void. You only ask because it's radically different from every other character that I have. Is it though?
A little bit. I guess with the piece that Nessiak found, from what I understand, this one has abs and eye hair.
You thought I made him in Spore or something? No. I do have like a Spore creature. I just have to find it.
Hello.
This is, I think, Derpus.
You are a Derpus.
You remember Derpus?
Of course I do. Who do you think I am? Some kind of freak? You guys remember Derpus?
I don't know if I was around for Derpus.
I don't know if you were either. But I remember Suze. Derpus.
Okay, Suze, I got a good one for you.
Hmm.
So I entered the fucking cookout yesterday. And when I started checking, like, the ELO and general rankings of everyone involved, because there's only, like, 16, 17 people in the whole thing, I looked at it and I said to myself, I think I might be a bit over-leveled for this. I was. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna need to wait for a second because I don't know why they haven't made the graphic yet, but, yeah. I did it. First place.
Hell yeah.
It was against Gold Lewis, so I loved when the commentators were like, now see, I think Jam Dacuzzi actually has the download, seeing as he won the last set. I think he's got it. And then I had to play, I shit you not, 12 games in a row. No.
What?
No 15. Way. Because I had to play loser's semis, into loser's finals, immediately into winner's finals, and then immediately into grand finals. And then because I was going in from losers, I had to reverse to do a bracket reset and do another first to three. Oh. Sorry.
Holy shit.
Yeah, it was a lot.
Just going for a freaking Grand Prix in that tournament, weren't you?
Yeah, no. But that's how you win. You know, you fucking
when you
get
said,
punched so many times.
When you said cookout, I'm not gonna lie, I legit thought you had entered like a cooking contest.
Yeah, first time I heard from him, yeah, I thought so too.
Susie, do you genuinely think that me, would actually trust myself enough to cook for other people?
I mean, weren't you, like, excited about the concept of possibly, like, having a restaurant or whatever?
Oh, yeah, that was my dad's.
Oh.
Yeah, my dad wants it because he thinks it'd be a cool business venture, and also he just doesn't want to be involved in the stock market anymore. He's like, I hate this. This is torture.
Still, I think that'd be pretty cool. Yeah. Just have a little barbecue cookout.
Yeah, no, I, because, what is it, if we were going to do something like that, we would have to do fish, because... You can't have a kosher pizza restaurant in San Diego. It's one of the unwritten laws of the city. if you have a kosher pizza restaurant, it will fail within a year. Like, you can set your watch. Because there are only two types of people who would eat there, and neither of them would eat there, because there's the, like, there's Jewish people who are, like, reformed or conservative, so they want to, like, they want to keep a bunch of the holidays and stuff, but don't want to, like, do kosher, because kosher is torture. And so they'll just eat somewhere else, where instead of having to pay, like, $20 for pretty good pizza, it's $6 for bad pizza, which is better. And then the other group is the exact opposite, where if you're too Jewish, you can't have milk, or unless it is, I believe, either from Israel or blessed by a rabbi, or both.
They have those?
Yup.
Huh.
Called Chol of Yisroel. And, yeah. So, the ultra-religious people won't go there, and then the conservative reform people won't go there, so that leaves, like, three families.
Hmm. Never heard of that before.
Yeah, so those don't fucking work. And for meat, you'd need a full-time mashgiach, and access to all of that kosher meat, which is not a thing you can do as, like, a family business. That's not possible. You'd need a foot in the OU for that. But with fish, it's a lot easier, because there's no specific way to kill the fish, so you can just get fish, and like, salmon's kosher. Anything with fins and scales, and it's not a bottom feeder, is kosher. Yeah, like, so having, like, fish and chips, and then, like, nigiri is, like, a fringe option, would just kind of be, like, most of the hypothetical menu. But in an instant where, like, that would happen, I would be trained for it. In this current circumstance, you could not put me in front of a grill and expect the food to be edible.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah. I'm not stupid, just inexperienced.
Yeah, I was also gonna say, I also never had your cooking before, so...
There are some things that I can definitely make. And you'll be a part of that, Susie, when the plan goes into action.
Wait, what plan?
But, you know, the plan. Anyway, the plan? So I'm actually pretty all right with making pozole. It's a Mexican dish that my mom taught me how to make. It's kind of like chicken soup. It's basically chicken soup, except you serve it with cilantro on the side. So you can, like, top your soup with, like, onion and fucking, like, shit and good food. There's, like, hominy in it. It's usually not spicy, but it's, like, kind of hot. And then I also make beef Wellington. Also pizza, but fucking anyone can make pizza.
Yeah.
It's the easiest food on this planet to make.
I can make ribs.
Okay, I might have to disagree with you on pizza being the easiest thing to make, because I think pasta is, like, borderline basic.
Well, here's the thing about the reason why I'd say pizza is because with pizza, you just kind of... You get your... What's it called? Your, You get tin foil. And then you nonstick spray it first.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have, like, a pre-existing crust, you throw a crust on, put sauce on, put cheese on, set the oven, throw it in. Mm-hmm. Whereas with pasta, it's still very simple. However, you need to, like, monitor it a lot. You have to stir it a lot. You have to make sure it's properly salted. Make sure you get it at the right spot to where it's not too not too stiff, not too soggy.
Okay.
Yeah, like, with pasta, it's a lot more, it's not a balancing act in the same way as like more complicated foods, but it's still like a little bit more delicate of a process. So also I'm gonna throw myself in a ditch if I can't pick up this fucking piece of my Gundam.
Are you making a model or playing the game? With the he's deafened. Never mind.
Yeah, I have no idea what plant he's talking about, by the way.
Oh, with the cooking or the Gundam?
The plan. Whatever the fuck that was.
Oh.
I have no idea what he's talking about, by the way.
I'm sure he's planning to make something for, like, lunch or a dinner if you ever meet in real life, I guess. That sounds like what the plan is to me.
God, imagine me meeting anyone.
Oh, I think it'd be pretty cool. I don't really know what we'd do if we actually met, but yeah, sounds nice.
I had a chance to meet Justin, but then I caught COVID.
Oh. Oh, man. God, 2019 really started a shitstorm, didn't it?
Man.
Possibly. Oh,
didn't exist.
Yeah. By the way, Avi, I was just explaining to Zinni that I have no idea what you mean by the plan.
Anyway, so, what are you drawing?
So I'm not supposed to know the plan. Got it?
It's a surprise plan that'll help us later.
That's what that tells me. I'm not supposed to know the plan.
Hold on, I need to DM you and totally not about the plan.
Gotcha, totally not about the plan.
Man, Newegg has really been a bitch, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I've been trying to order Ellie's new fucking PC, and I can't... Every time I try to ship it to her address, it's like, we can't find it. And I'm like, what do you mean? You can't find it.
I can't find it. There's only soup.
Yeah, but no, I
go to the next aisle!
Ellie lives in soup?
Well, because what keeps happening is that I told her, like, yo, make an account on Newegg, and she's like, okay, I made an account on Newegg. Still doesn't show up. All right, did you set your address on there in the thing? No, sets that. Still doesn't work. Okay, can you, like, try checking out but not actually buying anything? All right, did it. Okay, does it work? No. Call customer service. All right, it's... calls customer service. Sorry, we're closed at 5 o'clock. It's 5:01.
Shitting me.
I'm gonna kill myself. So then, on Monday, I'm
Don't
gonna
kill yourself.
Call customer service. And then I'm gonna be like, hey, dickheads. It's me. Going to shit in your mom's ass game. here to ask you a simple question. Why? Ask a more complicated question. Why the fuck can I not... fucking send my friend a goddamn PC.
By the way, these elementals are looking really nice, Susie.
Alright, and I think that's the last ones that I need to do, like... Oh no, wait, I still have Rex in the Void.
Void.
Yeah, Void needs a new ref because I used like a weird pin for that.
I'm watching back over the matches from last night, and I didn't watch the tournament on the stream, so I didn't notice that the Gold Lewis I fought has, I shit you not, a Grandpa Max mod.
No way, that's from Pen 10?
Yeah, it's Grandpa Max. The coffin has the rust bucket on the front, and then it's his Ben 10 Ultimate Alien on the bottom.
Oh my god, yes.
And he's got like the flowery shirt, hell yeah.
Plumber is back in action.
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead, stop the stream. I've done my three. Later, chat.